The Grazing Resilience and Sustainable Solutions project is a 3-year project funded by the Queensland Government to assist graziers in reef catchments. The program is being delivered by the Department of Agriculture and Fisheries in partnership with natural resource management groups, North Queensland Dry Tropics, Fitzroy Basin Association and Burnett Mary Regional Group.
The focus of the GRASS program is to rehabilitate land in C&D condition. By developing a land management plan, graziers can outline the measures that will be used to rehabilitate these areas of poor condition.
The reason why we are participating in the GRASS program is because we have a lot of steep undulating country that has been subject to heavy grazing pressure in the past. As a result of this, we have a lot of areas of poor and degraded ground cover or no ground cover at all. We also have a lot of deep eroded gullies caused by fast moving water from no ground cover initially. We believe implementing these changes will promote more ground cover on our C&D class land, therefore reducing runoff and preventing any further erosion.
The GRASS program provides one-on-one assistance to ensure that graziers are operating within the minimum standards set by the reef regulations legislation.
One of the requirements within the new legislation is that graziers keep grazing records and undertake a land condition assessment as of the 30th of September each year to ensure that ground cover is maintained at 50% or above. By developing and implementing a land management plan, graziers can identify areas of poor or degraded land and come up with action plans about how to remediate this land.
Graziers participating in the GRASS program will have the opportunity to voluntarily provide their details in order to be listed as low compliance in the new reef protection regulations.
The first standard is that for land that is in good or fair condition, continue to use measures that maintain that land in good or fair condition. Land that is in good or fair condition is determined as land that has 50% or above ground cover as of the 30th of September each year. The second standard is that for land that is in poor condition, measures must be implemented to improve the land condition to good or fair. The third standard is that for land that is in degraded condition, measures must be implemented to improve that land towards good or fair condition, or prevent the area from further degradation or expansion. Through working with DAF and NRM Extension officers on the GRASS program, graziers can access a range of incentives to assist with property infrastructure, such as additional water points, land type fencing and erosion control. The land management plans are supported by a mapping package that has been developed by the Department of Agriculture and Fisheries. Graziers are also able to access a range of extension advice through the Department of Agriculture and Fisheries or the Natural Resource Management Group. This includes advice on things such as nutrition, genetics and business management.
The benefit of the GRASS program to the grazing industry will be for graziers to limit the amount of sediment that runs off their properties into reef catchments.
I feel that it will give graziers the tools and knowledge to make better informed decisions on how to better manage their C&D class land, which in turn will promote better ground cover, less runoff and a more sustainable industry.
Graziers who are located within a reef catchment and are interested in becoming part of the GRASS program can contact their local DAF or NRM Extension officer to get involved.